Hello everyone, Adam here. Today we're gonna create a BadUSB device, so something that will allow you to hack a PC with Windows, for example, using a USB connection. There's a nice tutorial on this page, DevCraze tutorial cybersecurity create a Rubberducky using Arduino that we're gonna use in this video. And to do this device, you would need to purchase something like this, which is sometimes called SS Beetle or Arduino Micro Beetle, something that is clone of Arduino Leonardo device. It is even shown here that you need something like this. And you can buy it, for example, on Chinese shops like AliExpress.com. And there are basically two versions of this device. So first one is using 5 volts and it's cheaper, and I would recommend for this particular scenario this device. You can find it for something like less than $10, $9, something like this. And there's also second version which operates on 3.3 volt, and this one is very useful to connect, for example, to boards that require such voltage like 3.3. For example, CC1101, so the radio board. So you may consider this if you plan to build something similar to Yardstick 1, for example. Okay, so I've purchased one of these, and I will now unpack it, and we're gonna see if that works and what we can do with this tutorial, which is mentioning that this device is actually behaving like a keyboard and automates key presses, and it can execute a lot of commands in a very short time. So there's a kind of exploit in the PCs because they always trust human, and the USB device will behave as a human user interface device, so the ordinary keyboard, and that is why we can cheat on the PC. So let's get started. I have purchased one of these devices, and you can see it right here. So I've spent something like $8, I believe. So there's only a board and some pins. Those pins we are not gonna use in this scenario, in this BadUSB project. Let's now unpack it. We have the board, we have the pins. Maybe I will now show you. Oh. No. So we have this Atmega 32U4, the Atmega chip, the equivalent of the Atmega 328, but with the USB connectivity. We have a small crystal on board, so this board is operating on 16 megahertz, and some diodes and resistors to feed the USB TTL levels, and that's all. On the other side there's nothing. So if you want, you may solder these pins to the board, but in this particular scenario we are not going to solder anything. We simply attach this board as it is to the PC. Okay, let's now start with the board. So first you have to download the software, the Arduino software, which is available for Windows, Linux and Mac OSs. And after you start it, you have to configure this Arduino framework to operate with your board, and to do that first you have to attach the board to the PC and see what is the COM port that is used by this board. So as you can see, in my case it is COM7. In the Arduino you have to go to the tools section, select the board Arduino Leonardo, which is in the section Arduino AVR boards. Maybe also you would need to configure the COM ports if it's not detected automatically. And then you can start with the programming. So first let's put some empty script and see if this works. Okay, it was uploaded. So it now works and we can now start with the BadUSB payloads. Okay, let's now start with the first payload. So that will be something that will launch a notepad and leave some text in it, like you have been pwned. So to do that, you have to copy this file, this content to the Arduino. I did this, and what I did else is actually I have increased the delay values, because the 10 milliseconds initial value was introducing some issues in my case. And that was all what I have done. So let's see what it does actually. So it runs the notepad, so left GUI and R button, then launches notepad, then it puts some text into the notepad. Then after 5 seconds, it should select all the text and delete it by pressing delete button, and then it should close your window. So it will leave some trace, some empty file at the end, but meanwhile we'll be seeing some text. So I have already programmed this this board, and I will now attach it. So I have my desktop running, and now I'm attaching the board. So you can see the text, and the text will be deleted in 5 seconds, I believe. Yes, as you can see, it works, and it should at the end close the window, but in my case it didn't do this. I don't know why. So let's check another payload. The second file, the payload that we're gonna try, is a payload dropper. So there'll be some script that will download some file and execute it. So actually the one from this site, in my case, it didn't work. So I've managed to prepare my own. So in my case, there will be some PNG. So the image that will be downloaded to the desktop. The cats JPEG, and then there'll be application launched to display this, and as you can see, the PowerShell will be used and it will be launched in the hidden mode that will be not so visible to the end user of the PC. So let's now upload this and we're gonna see how it works in a second. Okay, so it is now uploaded. Okay, now it launches the PowerShell. And voila, as you can see, it launched the image from the desktop, and this image was previously downloaded from the internet. So this is a payload dropper, so I hope you like it. Okay. Next one. Okay guys, and the last payload today, there will be something that will steal Wi-Fi passwords and save it to the file, and after that it will try to FTP this data to some hidden hacker server. But in my case, I will not FTP this data, but simply save it to the file, just to show you that it is working correctly. So in my case, this script from this site, it didn't work. I used this one for 85 Pullman's rubber ducky, and I modified it slightly. So it basically dumps the data into the XML file, and then it tries to FTP this data. And what I did, I simply changed the name from Digi keyboard to keyboard, and that's all basically. Okay. Let's see how it works. So if I have already programmed this one, so I will now minimize this and let's see how it works. Let me see. So it launches a shell, and these data are already stored into the file Wi-Fi pass. So it doesn't FTP anything, because I would have to put here some valid HTTP server address. So it will, this script will actually use a post method, just to show you that these files already exist. I will try to make a dir command. I will not display them because they contain my passwords. Okay, as you can see, these two are dumped, and I'm actually connected to one of these networks, as you can see. Okay, basically that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you like it. So if you did, please press a like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you very much and hope to see you again. Bye bye.